بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده نستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to Allah. We ask His help and forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our bad deeds. Whomever Allah guides, no one can lead him astray, and whomever Allah leads astray, no one can guide him. I bear witness that there is no God to be worshipped except Allah alone. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His last messenger and His servant sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, O you who have believed, fear Allah as He should be feared, and never die except in the state of Islam, in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ba'du, respected elders, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today, inshallah, we will continue talking about the religion of Islam and to know its easiness, which the Prophet mentioned, alayhi salatu wasalam. Our religion is very easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah doesn't burden any soul, any person beyond his ability. Subhanahu wa ta'ala is very merciful towards His people, or towards His creatures, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today I have some stories, some situations happened at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and some of the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, they started to worship Allah in a way, and they start to overload themselves why they are not required to overload themselves. But Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam directed them and he corrected their ideas sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And the first story, the first situation I will start with today, رواه الإمام مسلم في صحيح عن حنظلة رضي الله عنه أنه قال لقيني أبو بكر يوما حزينا فقال ما لك يا حنظلة؟ فقال نكون عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيذكرنا بالجنة والنار فكأن رأي العين، فإذا خرجنا من عنده عافسنا الزوجات والأولاد والضيعات، نسينا كثيرا نافق حنظلة. حنظلة رضي الله عنه one of the Sahaba of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, once upon a time Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu passed by me and he found me very sad. So Abu Bakr asked Hanzala, what's up, ya Hanzala? Why are you so sad? فقال Hanzala, I became a hypocrite. Abu Bakr got surprised. Why are you a hypocrite? فقال Hanzala to ya Abu Bakr, when we sit with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and he talks, he reminds us with the Jannah and with the hellfire, we feel that we are inside the Jannah. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about the paradise, we feel we're in the paradise. When he talks about the hellfire, we feel we're in the hellfire. When he talks about the signs of the hereafter, the last day, we feel we live in the hereafter, in the last day. And when we leave him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to go out of the masjid, we attend our wives, our children, we take care of our business, and we forget most of what he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't feel the same. فقال أبو بكر رضي الله عنه سبحان الله والله إني لأجد ذلك. هيا بنا إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أبو بكر رضي الله عنه سبحان الله, I find the same. The same happens to me. It means Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه is a hypocrite or something. He is the first person in this ummah after the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Of course, there is something else. They have to learn from رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام. Sometimes when you are in the masjid, you may raise your hand to pray, to make dua, you may cry. You feel that you're in the Jannah. You're in the hellfire, the Imam is talking about the Jannah or the hellfire in a good way or something. You feel that you're in the Jannah. You're seeing the Jannah in front of your eyes. Like, you know, if some of our youth watches an action movie, he feels like he's inside the movie. And it appears on his reaction, his movements while watching the movie. The same happened with the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, but with a big difference. It was about the Jannah and the Nar with Rasulullah, and it's a movie. Anyways, he doesn't feel the same outside the masjid. So when they went to Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, Ya Rasulullah, we feel different when we leave you. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, to teach them, to correct their ideas. قال لو تدومون على الحالة التي تكونون عليها عندي وعلى الذكر لصافحتكم الملائكة في الطرقات وعلى فرشكم ولكنها ساعة وساعة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to them, if you remain the same state as it is when you are with me in my presence and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at every time, the angels of Allah may check out with you in your boats and in your beds. But it's sa'atu wa sa'a means sometimes should be given, should be devoted to Allah, to the masjid, to pray in the masjid, and some other time should be devoted to your worldly affairs. شؤون الدنيا صلى الله عليه وسلم. So you have a sa'ah inside the masjid to pray at night and to cry and to make dua and to recite the Quran and to feel khushu'. And another sa'ah to go to work, to care of your children, to provide your family, to care of your health, to have some entertainment. And if you clarify your intention in the other sa'ah while you're outside the masjid, if you clarify your intention, I provide myself, I provide my family for the sake of Allah, I study for the sake of Allah, I work for the sake of Allah, all of your life will be like a kind of worship and you will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you have to understand by the end of the discussion that it's sa'atun wa sa'ah, as he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At some time, you feel your iman is very high, and some other time, your iman is lower. As he said عليه الصلاة والسلام, إن الإيمان لا يخلق في جوف أحدكم كما يخلق الثوب. فاسألوا الله أن يجدد الإيمان في قلوبكم. Your iman become weaker in your heart. So ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to renew the iman in your heart. اللهم جدد الإيمان في قلوبنا يا رب. So that's the first story. The second situation, سيدنا عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه في صحيح البخاري ومسلم وغيرهم قال أخبر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنني أقول لأصومن الليل لأصومن النهار ولأقومن الليل ما حييت. سيدنا عبد الله بن عمرو said the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام was informed that I have said I will fast every day and I will pray every night forever. I'll never leave pray at night. I'll never break my fast. And you know it's not allowed. You're not allowed to fast every day. You're not allowed. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا صام من صام الدهر. لا صام من صام الدهر. The one who fasts every day, he's not fasting. Why? Because we have some days during the week where you're not allowed, when you're not allowed to fast. Like in the first day of Tashriq, in Eid al-Adha, and the first day of Eid al-Fitr. So you have some time to break your fast. قال عبد الله بن عمرو فدعاني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال أنت الذي قلت ذلك؟ قال نعم يا رسول الله. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, he called عبد الله بن عمرو said, it is you who said, I will fast and pray at night every day forever. He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, I am a young man. And I can't do that. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, لا تفعل. لا تفعل. Subhanallah, he is correcting his mind, his ideas. عليه الصلاة والسلام, your religion is easy. It's not difficult. When a minister prayed to the youth, why you don't come to the masjid? Some of them said, we live away from the masjid. Some of them say, we have some other commitments, we have lots of homework. Some others said, I'm at work at that time, I'm prepared, so I pray at workplace. Some others said, we don't come to the masjid because some people just try to overload us and always to criticize us. They are making our life more difficult. That's why we don't come to the masjid. Some of them said that. Rasulullah alayhi wasallam said to Abdullah ibn Amr, Ya Abdullah ibn Amr, don't do that. Just fast and break your fast. Pray at night and sleep. And then he said, and fast 3 days every month. Only 3 days. فقال عبد الله يا رسول الله إني شاب وإني أطيق أكثر من ذلك. He said, I'm a young man and have the strength, have the energy to fast more. I can observe more fasting 3 days always. Crazy. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. So he went to he directed him to a higher level. He said to them, فصوم يوما وأفطر يومين. Then fast one day and break your fast for 2 days. فقال, I'm a young man, I can't fast more. فقال صوم يوما وأفطر يومين. So observe fasting every other day. فقال يا رسول الله, إني أطيق أكثر من ذلك. I'm a young man, I have the strength, I can do more than that. فقال النبي, listen, قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, لا أفضل من ذلك. Nothing is better than this. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Just fast every other day. Do not overload yourself. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So another situation happened, and most of you know it. When the three people came to the house of Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام to ask his wives about his worship. How does he worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى? And they know the difference between them and Rasulullah. When he was informed about his kind of worship, and they got surprised and they said, SubhanAllah, إِنَّهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مَنْ تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ دَبْيَ مَنْ تَفْرِ. He's Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام, and Allah SWT has forgiven for him all of his past and future sins. But as for us, compared to Rasulullah, we have to increase our duties. So one of them said, I will fast every day. أما أنا فأصوم النهار أبدا. وقال آخر, أما أنا فأقوم الليل أبدا. وقال ثالث, أما أنا فلا أتزوج النساء. وقال رابع, فأما أنا فلا آكل اللحم. In another narration, one of them said, I will fast every day forever. The second one, I will pray at night every day forever, every night. The third one said, I will not get married. The fourth one, in another narration, instead of the third one, in this narration, he said, I won't eat meat. I won't eat meat. So when Rasulullah ﷺ heard of that, he called him ﷺ and said, I am the nearest one, the closest one to you, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the most one who fear Allah. But as for me, I fast, and I break my fast. I pray at night, and I sleep. And I eat meat, and I get married, and it's my sunnah. And if you keep away from my sunnah, so you're not from me. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Man raghiba an sunnati falaysa minni. Your religion is easy. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam migrated from Mecca to Al-Madinah, he started to establish the pillars of the new Islamic state, the real Islamic state. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the first step to build the real Islamic state is the masjid. The first thing he took on Islam is to build the masjid. Second step, he started to make the bond of the brotherhood among the Muslims. Al-ukhuwa bayn al-Muslimin. Third step is the constitution. How the Muslims deal with one another, how the Muslims deal with others other than Muslims. So he made the bond of brotherhood between Salman al-Farisi wa Abu Darda. رضي الله عنه. So Abu Darda and Salman al-Farisi now are brothers in Islam. Salman al-Farisi, he went to visit his brother Abu Darda. قال فوجدت أم الدرداء متبذلة. He just found Umm al-Darda dressed in shabby clothes. She doesn't take care of herself. Then Abu Darda رضي الله عنه came. فقال سلمان لأم الدرداء ما شأنك؟ فقالت أخوك أبو الدرداء ليس له حاجة في الدنيا. Your brother Abu Darda is not interested in the luxuries of this life. He doesn't care. He doesn't want to. He is not interested in this dunya. He just looks for the akhirah. He prays every night, the whole night. Fasts every day, always. Remember Allah reciting the Quran, and that's very good from our side. From our side. But from the side of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's different. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu prepared some food to his brother Salman. And he said to him, please eat. Here you go. فقال سلمان لن أكل حتى تأكل. فقال أبو الدرداء I'm fasting. Salman said to him, the guest, Salman said to the host, Abu Darda, I won't eat until you eat. You have to eat first. فقال I'm fasting. He said, no, you have to eat. So Abu Darda broke his fast. Then when they went to sleep, Abu Darda radiallahu anhu woke up to pray at night, as he used every day to pray at night, every day to fast. فقال له سلمان, please come to sleep. Not now, not yet. We're not praying at night yet. Come, sleep. Then he slept. Then Abu Darda woke up again to pray. Sulaiman said to him, please come sleep. And he slept. And when it was the last hours of the night, Abu Darda radiallahu anhu got up, or Salman got up, and he woke up Abu Darda and said to him, please wake up, we have to pray. That's the time of the Tahajjud prayer. As you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَدْرِ لِلسَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ فِي الثُّلُثِ الْآخِرِ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ Allah sends every night to the lower heaven to ask, مَنْ الَّذِي يَدْعُونِي فَأَسْتَجِيبَ لَكَ Who is supplicating me, so I will respond to him. He's asking me, I will give him. He's asking my forgiveness, I will forgive him. At the last third of the night, the best time. So Salman said to him, please now, you pray. And they prayed in congregation. Then when it was the morning, Abu Darda went to Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam. He's not convinced with what Salman said to him. He wants to pray every day and to fast every day and to pray the whole night. Then he went to Rasulullah عليه الصلاة والسلام. Rasulullah التزم وقال له صدق سلمان. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام smiled and said سلمان was right. سلمان said to Abu Darda, إن لبدنك عليك حق وإن لربك عليك حق وإن لأهلك عليك حق وإن لعينك عليك حق وإن لزورك عليك حق فأعطي كل ذي حق حق. You owe a duty to your Lord, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you owe a duty to your body. You owe a duty to your family. You owe a duty to your wife, to your children. You owe a duty to your visitors. So you're not allowed in our religion to overload yourself. Our religion is easy. وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم استغفروه من كل ذنب إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا حمدا والشكر له شكرا شكرا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Some people try to innovate new kind of worships and they are not required to do that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't require you and He will not reward you for any kind of worship He didn't order you to do. Like Rasulullah, for example, he was standing with a member on Friday giving the khutbah. And he found a man standing up. Then he asked alayhi salatu wasalam, who is that man? Why is he standing up? And then the duty of the imam, when he sees anything happening in the khutbah, he should make a comment, he should correct the people. That was his habit alayhi salatu wasalam. Who is that man? فقال يا رسول الله هذا أبو إسرائيل This narration reported by Imam Muslim عن سيدنا ابن مسعود. هذا الأب الإسرائيلي نذر أن يقوم ولا يقعد وألا يستظل وألا يتكلم ويصوم. He made an oath over himself to stand up and not to sit down, and not to get into shade, and not to talk, just to keep silent and to fast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't ask him to stand up. Allah didn't ask him to stand up in the under the sun and not to get into a shade. Allah didn't ask him to keep silent. But Allah asked him to fast. So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said to them, مُرُوهُ فَلْيَقْعُدْ وَلْيَسْتَظِلْ وَلْيَتَكَلَّمْ وَلْيُتِمَّ صَلَّهُ. Look at this fiqh عليه الصلاة والسلام. Said to them, order him or let him speak, get into a shade, and to sit down and to continue fasting. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So don't overdo yourself. Overdoing is easy. قال تعالى ما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج. Allah has not placed any hardship upon you in religion. وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وإني داعٍ. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا، اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا، واستر عيوبنا، وتول أمرنا، وأحسن خلاصنا، وفك أسرنا، ويرحم كتابنا، ويسر حسابنا، ويسر على الصراط مرورنا، وصل اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.